when we stand before Almighty God, He's not going to ask us how well dressed we are. He's not going to ask us how many trips we made or how important we were. He is going to ask us, and we're going to tell Him how much the world is better because we've been in it, for His sake and for the sake of others. It's a thrilling opportunity. Time doesn't allow to tell people like you how wonderful you are, the terrific things you can do. Most of us go through life hitting on one cylinder. We could hit on eight. Any motor works better hitting on all eight anyhow. To live the fullness of your life. You see, right in your midst, there are many people doing this. There are many people right up here. I remember years ago when Martin Quigley, 20 years ago when I first had the pleasure of meeting, 21 years ago, what he was doing. He wasn't in the motion picture field just to get out of it. He wanted to make it better for his being in it. And every waking moment has been direct, is not objective. How does he know until he stands before God how many of the 200 million people who see American films all over the world, how much better those films have been because he has been in it? Leo McCarey didn't start in high, he started way down. I'm sorry I didn't tell you about the beginnings, the hard knocks. And the hard knocks that have gone all the way through. Don't ever forget it. If you ever want to win in the name of Christ, you have to lose all the way through. You have to lose to the very end. Life is not a popularity contest. But what were my stories? Not what I'm doing. I'm doing nothing except having a good time. It's a thrill. Gee. But what you're doing, what people like you are doing, and it comes from such a variety of sources. We're using the movies. It's our most effective way of spreading the whole idea. Our first film, which Leo McCarey, thank God, helped us with and brought its light and humor and lesson into it, is gone. We have 1,800 copies of that moving around every place. We just finished another. We're using the movies to improve television. We just finished a movie called Television Is What You Make It. It arrived last night. The night before last in Hollywood, a young chap with Columbia Pictures did it, Jules Bergen. He did a magnificent job. We're doing two more in California in the next couple of months. So one is called Government Is Your Business, and the other one on atomic energy. I'll tell you, just closing, how the one on atomic energy got started. We moved into our office here on 48th Street 2 years ago last October. Just in the process of moving, and a man came in from the atomic energy. It's bad enough to have the mover in. We'll have to have somebody from Atomic Energy. And he said, I hear the Christians are going to make 30 movies. He said, won't you please make one on atomic energy? And I said, now listen. I said, we're just a little peanut stand. He said, I don't care how little you are. He was throwing it right back in my face. He said, I don't care how little you are. You can, just a small effort might turn this whole future, the whole future of this terrific power. He said, if we could only see that this is the power that's been put in our hands by God and it can be used for research and medicine and agriculture industry in a thousand different ways, it may change the whole future of mankind. And he says, if somebody doesn't give it that slant, that color, he said, most of us may be blasted off the face of the earth. So God's doing it. We're not doing it. But I'm so afraid if we start trying to do it, He'll let us do it. Then we will be out in left field. Second, well, he wasn't convinced of that. He said to me, that's all very good, but I see you got it right here. Well, this must have been the Holy Ghost furnishing what I didn't have. I said, now listen, you. I said, I know this is passing up something very good, but I'll guarantee you, as sure as you're sitting there, that I'll get $100,000 by this time next year, and I won't have to work for it. He walked away. A week later, he sent $5,000
anyhow. So
you have to remember the four words of Christ. It's so simple. Life could be so simple, but the Chinese say everybody wants to make it complex.
Didn't pay his money, and something's going out.